Hey guys, welcome back to another tutorial. I'm a little bit late with this one. This is one of my usual cake challenges that we hold in the brigade. All the members were amazing as usual and got their pieces finished on time. It was me that was late. Sorry. This was the mood board we were working off. They voted for the theme Pastel Winter. Don't forget to stick around to the end of the video to vote on your favourite piece, as the winner does get a prize. From this mood board, I spotted this little grey cat in the top left corner and decided just to make a model this time round. I've got a polystyrene block just covered in a piece of kitchen roll, just because the underneath is full of luster dust and colouring stains. I'm starting off by mixing a grey using white sugar paste and black sugar paste. Everything I use will be linked in the description box below. I prefer to mix paste with paste rather than paste with gel colouring, as it can sometimes make it a little bit too sticky. I'm just rolling a crack-free ball first and then into a chubby oblong, slightly smaller at the top, and then rubbing my finger across the middle to give it a little belly. For the legs, I'm rolling out a ball of grey paste and extending out one long piece. Kind of looks a bit like an AirPod at this stage. You then want to squash the fat apart into a disc, and this is going to form the cat's leg. I'm just pressing the disc flat against the side near the bottom and curling the longer piece up to form the leg and paw. I'm just curling the sausage over for the paw and forming a tiny little point where the leg bends. I'm then marking in two lines to create the toes and curling them over. The next leg is made in the exact same way, but I'm placing it in a slightly different position. We can get carried away sometimes with making things symmetrical and perfect, but it always pays to have a little play around with the limbs for a more playful look. For this one, I'm bending it a little more across the body. The tail is a simple, thin grey sausage, chopped down, and I'm lifting the bum to secure the tail underneath it, and then just winding it into a playful position. I've then got some lilac paste, this is where the pastel winter part comes in, and I'm cutting out a scarf. It's just a long strip with little tassels cut out with a scalpel at the end. And I'm cutting it into two shorter pieces so I can wrap it around the body and chop it behind the neck. Before sticking this down into position, I'm going to create the front paws, which is a long sausage with the end flattened and a Dresden tool run across the top to create three little toes. I've chopped it down in length and at an angle so that the leg will fit flat against the body, and then I'm wrapping it over the scarf, bending the paw downwards. I'm then taking the other piece of scarf and wrapping it across before adding another paw. I'm just bending the paws down together in the centre to create a cute, innocent look. The head starts as a slightly flattened oval, which I'm cutting the very top off with a sharp, straight knife, and then I'm doing the exact same with a lilac colour. You want to merge the two together by patting and stroking the paste together. This is the cat's face with his little lilac hat. I'm covering the join with a sausage of pink paste and then attacking it with the sharp end of my Dresden tool to pull out a fluffy effect. I'm holding the head where I want to place it on the body and then pushing down two cocktail sticks to hold it in place. This is where I usually make all my models directly on the cake, so these cocktail sticks would have originally gone into the cake, but instead we're using a polystyrene block. The ears start as a grey teardrop that is flattened, and then a matching pink one is laid over the top, slightly smaller. You just want to trim across to create this pointy little ear, and I'm sticking this on top of the hat. All my paste is currently tacky enough to stick without water, but you can always add a little bit of water or edible glue if needed. I'm then adding some little lines in the centre of the ears for a bit more detail. Back to the grey again, I'm running my little finger across the centre of a very short sausage to make a sort of jelly bean shape, and then sticking a little oval inside the gap to create the cat's mouth. You just want to score a line upwards to where the nose would be. The nose is a more pale pink, squashed on and tapped into a slight V shape at the bottom with a Dresden tool. And I'm also adding little dots where the whiskers would be. Back to that slightly darker pink for a bobble on top of the hat. This is textured in the same way with the Dresden tool to make it fluffy. Back again to the pale pink, I'm adding very, very small balls for the cat's little toe beans, a slightly larger pad and three smaller ones for the toes. To give the cat an expression, we are pushing in either side with the Dresden tool. You can see as I hold it straight on that the cat now looks like it's smiling. Its eyes are closed, so I'm just marking this in with some black paint in little curves, and I'm adding some pink luster to the cheeks and nose. The last detail is some stripes. This paint is white dust mixed with black gel and water to create a dark grey paint, which I'm then just adding to the legs, tail, arms and face. And that's it, we're done. This is a cute, playful and cosy cat for my interpretation of the pastel winter mood board. Coming up next, you'll see the mood board again that we worked from, followed by the Brigadier's individual pieces. Vote for your favourite in the comments below using the corresponding letter. Hopefully this comes in handy for you and you enjoyed watching a model tutorial for a change. And don't forget to subscribe to see all the upcoming tutorials, and I'll see you again in the next one. Bye guys.